Hi, I'm Stacey from the Great British Florist, and today I'm going to show you how to make our traditional rustic jug arrangement for the table centre. What you're going to need is to have with you is a nice spray set on the really fine mist, some twine, some string, or something to tie your posy together, obviously the jug for it to go into, and a scissors and a secateurs. If you haven't got a secateurs, don't worry, a real sharp scissors will do. And of course, the most important thing is a selection of the kind of flowers you want to do. As you can see today, I've chosen to do our kind of autumn mix. So I've got some harvey and some eucalyptus. I've got some solly, or also known as goldenrod, but they're slightly different. I've got some barley. I've got some cardamus, which is known as orange thistle as well. Red hypericum berries, and I've got the spray version, not the single stem, but it doesn't matter for these purposes. I've got some cornflower because of this beautiful purpley blue, and I've got some real kind of tight red ulstromelia, ulstro I call them, and some nice purple brodia. Okay, so what you need to do first is, once your flowers have come out of the water, you need to really kind of condition them down to the length that you want. So we'll start with the foliage first. I'm going to start with parvy, and mainly parvy comes into you like so. Well, we only actually need the top part because we don't want any foliage in the water. Foliage will rot and cause bacteria and will cause your flowers to die. So what we're going to do is just simple. You can cut them off if you wish. I tend to pull it because parvy is quite thick. So just remove any ones that we don't want. This is quite a tall piece, so I'm just going to remove quite a lot from this stem, and tend to get yourself a nice kind of selection of different bits, because if you look at your jug, you want it to be quite wild and natural. Okay, just go through some of your parvy, just making sure, and I'd say kind of small bunch is all you need. It's just to give it that kind of loose softness. All right, no more than kind of 10 stems. Then I've got some eucalyptus. Now eucalyptus tends to come in this horrendously big and overpowering size. All you're gonna do, dead simple, don't panic. Take your scissors, and we're just gonna cut all these bits off to single stems. Just like so. And as you go down, they'll just show smaller ones, but we can put those to the outside. Never throw anything away. Okay, and then we've got a little bit left over. And what you do with your eucalyptus is you take the length that you want, taking your hand, you just slide down. There's no thorns or anything in eucalyptus, so you're not gonna hurt yourself. And you normally, you just want the top and you want the stems to be nice and clean. It makes it easier to put together. On the shorter bits, again, keep just the top couple, because you still need all the stems to reach the water. Okay, keep going. It does feel like it goes on forever, but you'll get there in the end. Then with your cardamus, it tends to come in kind of like this. Sometimes they have leaves going all down the stems. Choose the length that you want. Remove any of the leaves below. And this seems quite brutal, but the reason why I'll do it and I'll show you is, when it goes in to your posy, you don't actually want all those leaves around the bottom. They tend to have a growing point in cardamus, which is right here, where they've cut off the top to encourage the others. What you need to do is just cut that back. And look, check any of the hairs. If there are any of the hairs you don't like the look of, chop them off as well. Continue with those. Three stems of cardamus would be more than enough. But as you can see, this one that's just not grown right, gone a little bit over, just chop him off. The golden point, give a really nice orangey texture. I've got some barley here. This is dried barley, but all you need to do is just remove the lower leaves, the kind of wispy bits at the top, leave on, because they actually give a lovely color to it. Then with our solly, what I need to do is, I just want the puffy stuff up the top that's showing. Everything else will be just pulled off. You can just literally pull it off. Don't tend to take your hands down this. They can be quite sharp bits and woody bits. It's such a woody plant, so just take it off slowly, so you've got a nice clean stem. Just literally want the top bit. Now, hypericum, the leaves are lovely on it, and it's not so bad. If you were doing it in butternut, you'd take all these leaves off because they tend to go brown quite quickly and wilt. But just have a little look around. Remove anything that you don't like the look of. If they've got yellow bits like that, that's just its flower. If you like it, fine, keep it. If not, it'll easily just pull off. Cornflower gives us this lovely kind of wild look in there. And what you need to do is, it does have leaves that come all the way down to the bottom. And what you need to do is just remove any that you don't need. Like, these are too long, these lower parts are too long, so we just gently pull them off. You have to be a little bit careful with cornflower because it is a little bit fragile. Right, then we come to our Australia. The loose leaves kind of grow up and wilt, and you don't really want that. So what you just keep is the bottom part where you can see the flowers come out from. Keep the leaves on the top, just rub your hand down and remove the bottom. Then lastly, we're going to put little sprigs of grosgrove. They don't actually need any conditioning. If there are brown bits on there that you don't like the look of, remove them, but they're kind of broken bits, you can just take off and they will just easily pull off, but they don't really come with any leaves, or it's just a case of cutting the stems. And that's our flowers. Okay, now we've prepared all our flowers ready for the posy. What we need to do is kind of select different foliage. I like to use the eucalyptus to the center, going out to the parvi, which makes it, but you can use it as you like. For the purposes of today, I'm going to choose a central, and I normally put two barley, wheat, or it could literally be one stem of hypericum if you want, but I use this for the middle and then spread it throughout. Now, we use spiraling technique on this because it's nice and loose and you want it to be kind of like it's scooped up in a meadow somewhere. So what I'll do is I'll just go through all of them and I'll be laying them up as we go. But it's completely up to you how you want it. If you want it in sections, put them in sections. If you want it in blocks, you can do blocks. It's up to you. But I kind of like using looser ones to the center. And I tend to do a little bit of one of each as we go around. That's what kind of makes it so loose. What's really good with the cornflower is if you lift it up, like it's growing up, it can make it really, really wild. If you don't like it so wild, lower it down so it's in, and it'll make it a tighter bouquet. But for these purposes, we're going to pop him up. You want everything to kind of have its own house. So you just want to... Yes. Now, I've got a spiraling technique starting. You can't quite see it fully, but you kind of twist as you go around, and it makes it lovely and loose. Don't forget to put your barley, because you want continuous of barley in there. How you add it is up to you. I like going in threes, but you can do it ones of each and twisting as you go. You can just grab. Cool. Now, I find rhodia can be sometimes a little bit thin, so I tend to loop two together and put them in, but again, you can do it however you fancy. Cartamus is quite striking, and as it stands up, can see it'll automatically spread out, so it kind of lends to the shape. So you can just put it where you fit. Just like carting some berries together, but it's up to you. A bit of solid over here. Don't forget to get your cornflowers in and nice and high. Really separate the flowers out as you go. You still with me? You can do it. Focus on. Now, you just need to know you don't need to use everything, but just get a good mixture. Don't forget to add your foliage. It gives it the kind of wild texture. Look at it once in a while, see what you're missing, where you want things to go. I need some yellow over here, just to support. Look through my berries. Yeah. if it's too big, don't be afraid to peel it off as you go. And don't forget your bouquet. Gives it a nice light. Keep checking as you go in. Make it nice and kind of white. Now, at this stage, I think that we've got enough in there. Maybe a little bit looser over here. And then complement it a little bit over here. What you need to do now is once you've got as much as you like in there, you need to kind of support the stems and give them a little bit of protection. And this is when we tend to put some foliage through. So you can either do a mixture, which I'm going to do today, or you can actually just use your parvi, or just a yucco, or whatever you like, or none at all, it's up to you. I think it just tends to finish it off quite sweetly. Just keep putting it around, keep it spiraling, because it's nice and loose and open. And again, if you want it smaller and just a few stems, you can do a few stems. You want it bigger and keep going. Keep going. Bring it around quite nice. And then maybe for good measure, put a little bit of wheat at the bottom. Use your little sprig of sunken it down, but remember you need to cut that off so that it drinks. And take a look at it head on. Check that you're happy. I think it needs a little bit more over here, so I'm going to just add a few bits in here. And if you're happy with it and finished, which I think I have, get yourself some of your twine and we're just going to tie it off. Now you can do it with ribbon, you can do it with an elastic band. It's completely up to you. We like twine. Bit nice and traditional. I tend to wrap it around a few times and then slightly lie and just tie off. Double knot it if you wish, double knot and bow it, but make sure there's a double knot that holds it together. Okay, and just cut off the waist that you don't want. Right, now the best way to do this is measure it up against your vase. Now I quite like mine sunken in that come to about here. But it's up to you, you can have it there. But I tend to think if you keep it quite sunken and quite grounded, it's nice. So what you do, and this is why we take 7 years, because some of these stems are quite woody. But if you have a sharp scissors, you can use a sharp scissors through there. And I tend to know these are about 2 handfuls. So I'm going to just cut here. Now, normally they tell you to cut it diagonal so the flowers grow. I tend to cut them flat for a wedding day so that they're not drinking too much water, so they're not going to run out of water. But again, it's up to you. If you are going to cut them to drink, it's at a 45 degree angle because the surface area that a flower drinks out of is quite small. So by doing it at a 45 degree angle, you're opening it up and encouraging it to drink more. Just chop them off and then remove any leaves. If you see any leaves below it, just make sure they're gone. And you're just going to pop it in your jug, settle it down. Make sure you have water in it, a little bit of flower food would be good. But other than that, give it a nice misting so it lasts through the day. And there you have it, your jug table centre.